what many people say were their glory days back years ago. But, you know, sources this week told me that JJ would indeed be named a spokesman for WCW here tonight as we await. We've talked about many times tonight during this telecast a major announcement concerning Eric Bischoff, his status, his dealings, his legal maneuvering, what has been going on since his suspension here tonight.
Fiasco in the South Tower, but maybe JJ will straighten it out.
So hopefully we will hear a little bit later on from James J. Dillon as he arrives limousine here tonight. A capacity crowd as always for WCW Monday Nitro. The United States Heavyweight Champion Dean Malenko makes his way to the ring. His opponent, Yuji Nagata, the youngster from Japan, from the New Japan Pro Wrestling Promotion, superior martial arts skill, and a man who knows Dean Malenko very, very well. They've wrestled together as a team. They've wrestled against each other many times. This should be a great matchup, Larry.
Now, obviously, the Japanese guy looks up to Malenko, that master that he is. Again, I think another maybe protege of Mr. Sonny Ono. I'm not positive, but it should be a good one. You know, the Japanese, everybody's got like a martial arts background there. They kind of are raised on martial arts like we're raised on football and baseball.
Yeah, you're right.
Second nature to them, but still, punches and kicks are great sometimes, but on the mat, Malenko is the man.
Nagata, one of the top cruiserweights from New Japan Pro Wrestling. First time we have seen him here on Nitro. What a program we have, ladies and gentlemen. We have three title matches in this two-hour program. Tonight, you're seeing the U.S. title on the line. Later on, the TV belt, Ultimo Dragon and Bobby Eaton. And six will defend the cruiserweight belt against Rey Mysterio Jr. later on tonight. What a match, and what a night we're having already.
Yeah, a good match. Malenko's one of my favorite guys. I mean, I'm a purist, so I love to watch Dean Malenko wrestle, especially a guy like this who can mix it up with the martial arts and the wrestling. But again, look at Malenko's strategy. Get the guy on the mat. Don't let the hands and feet become weapons.
Certainly, Dean Malenko, when you are on top, when you are a champion, you have your share of enemies. And Malenko has certainly garnered one enemy, a mortal enemy, if you will, in one Eddie Guerrero. Last week on this program, attempting to injure his older brother, Hector, Eddie came out, and I think we really saw and heard the dark side of Eddie Guerrero we had not heard or seen in many, many years.
Well, all the Guerreros, you know, it's a very emotional family, and I just think they can't take Malenko anymore. They've thrown so many family members, and Dean has beaten them all, and Eddie just can't wait to get him for revenge.
As he slowly gets to his feet here in the opening bout, Nagata snapmare takeover, and Nagata with a back leg front kick that time by Nagata, and then a reverse chin lock. And that kick between the shoulder blades was just a short notice to Dean Malenko that this man is not intimidated at all.
Yeah, there you go. Come on.
Second week in a row he has been with us. As you know, last week it was announced that he has signed for Slamboree to meet Steve Mongo McMichael one-on-one. You were looking right there as he's at ringside at the all-time sack leader in NFL history.
Well, that's not going to help him because there's no quarterbacks, there's no huddles, there's no 10 other guys making room for Reggie to run through. He's got one man to face and one man only without pads. And that's a man who's been getting some experience, brother.
Well, when you think about Reggie White and you think about the career he has had with the Packers.
You know, I don't think about Reggie White.
Well, I know many fans do. Maybe you don't. And you think about the career that Steve Mongo McMichael has with the Bears. You're looking at Slamboree. WCW is bringing the black and blue division. Bears versus Packers right to the ring. First time ever coming up on May 18th that two former Super Bowl champions, Reggie of the past Super Bowl and Steve McMichael of the Bears back in their glory days, 1986, have ever faced it one-on-one in the ring. I mean, you're talking about Bears versus Packers in the ring at Slamboree.
Without pads, finally like men, mano a mano. And, you know, it's not going to be a Greco-Roman textbook wrestling match, but it certainly is going to be like two semis running head on.
Boy, there's no question. Good looking, Reggie.
May 18th.
Me and you. Yes, his look last week in Philadelphia. He was just calmly watching the ringside, was just kind of absorbing everything that goes on. And now, seemingly, Reggie White is here tonight live with a purpose.
Yeah, but Mr. White here, he better realize that McMichael has been off the gridiron, and he's been involved with men who know wrestling. And even though Mongo isn't a very accomplished scientific wrestler, he knows a lot more in that ring than Reggie White does. So Mr. White has a big disadvantage as far as I'm concerned.
Well, I think you're right. But
I'm always right.
Well, no. I think Reggie, though, realizes this, and that does not deter him. He is not intimidated. And you are talking, when you think about Reggie White of the Packers, Steve McMichael of the Bears, two of the greatest defensive linemen the sport NFL football has ever seen, Larry.
So what do you want, the over or the under?
It's going to be exciting bringing that match to you at part of Slamboree. What rivalry over the decades, over the years, between those two great franchises in the NFL, and what a rivalry that's been going on here.
Oh, Malenko's making his move!
Malenko caught it, cover one, got a one count. That time, and Nagata finds himself in trouble. That was almost like a drop kick, but it hit him with the knee that time.
Yeah, he got him with the knee, and he bent over too soon, and that was a clumsy mistake.
Now,
oh, he caught him!
What about that? Nagata hitting him with those thrust kicks.
Yeah, fool me once, shame on you, but fool me twice, shame on me. And Malenko's not one man you can fool three times. He's going to hook you.
Yeah, the key to that, Larry, was absorbing those blows and rebounding the way he did. He backs away from the kick, but he couldn't back away from that standing sidekick. That caught him. Malenko back up. Good maneuver. It was over the top suplex and a release one. One, two, and he almost beat him that time.
Yeah, you know, and for all the mad expertise Malenko has, he spent so much time in the Orient, he's basically immune to the martial arts background. He's so used to competing against it. And look at right there. Heading the wrong place. Malenko nailed him. Oh, he ran into it.
Nice lock over the top. And a version of belly-to-belly suplex. Here's a cover. That time looks like he was trying to hook tights, but Malenko was able to kick away.
Trying to hook it, just couldn't hook them tights enough. But nice try. I approve of that.
I'm sure you do. And Nagata
caught him.
Oh, boy. How about an elbow drop?
On the knee, Tony, and he's setting him up if he can get this on. Going for the cloverleaf.
The standing in Saginaw, the United States champions, trying to turn him over.
Chin, that softened him up, got the elbow on the knee, weakened him, turned him over for the cloverleaf, sits down on the small of the back, and it's sayonara.